King of Egypt by Pam Rushby. Illustrated by Diana Platt. Preface. Many people in this story are made up, but some of them really lived in Egypt. Thousands of years ago, Hatshepsut ruled as pharaoh in the period called the 18th dynasty of the New Kingdom. She was married to Thutmosis II, and on his death, she took over the throne of Egypt because his son, Thutmosis III, by his second wife, was too young to rule. Senmut was also a real person. He was the chief steward of the palace and a very powerful man. If you ever visit Egypt, you can see Hatshepsut's temple. It is at Deir el-Bahari, near the valleys of the kings and queens. You will be able to find the carvings described in the story. Senmut, birds in the marshes, and the queen of Punt. 1. A waste of time. Great Aunt Aset was old. Her eyes weren't as sharp as they used to be, but they were sharp enough to see what my brother Setep and I were doing in the garden that afternoon. And she had a tongue that stung like a wasp. They're at it again, Great Aunt Aset hissed. The rest of my family looked up slowly. It was a hot afternoon, and the sun blazed down. Dust from the city streets of Thebes drifted over the high mud brick walls and hung in the air. We were all trying to keep cool in the shade of the garden in the center of our house. My father, Ames, was dozing. My mother, Nebet, sat beside him, sewing. My middle brothers, Hori and Beset, were playing a game. My youngest brother, Nefer, was laying near the fish pond, teasing the fish. And my oldest brother, Setep, and I, well, we were doing what had annoyed Great Aunt Aset. Setep was teaching me to read. Teaching a girl to read and write, snorted Great Aunt Aset. What a waste of time. You should be helping your mother sew.
On the next slide, you are going to answer, how do we know that this story is taking place in the past?